Hello all, welcome back to our channel Nursery to Versity. In this tutorial we are going to cover how can we create a React app and exploring JSX, that is JavaScript XML. So from now we will use VS Code for our React learning. When you open the VS Code you will see this kind of dashboard. So now we will see how we can create a React app. Okay, so you will see the terminal in your VS Code. Go to terminal, new terminal. Then type npx create react app, then your app name, let's say learning one. This will create a new React app, that's name is learning one. It will install all the packages and React DOM also. This might take some time. I am pausing for a while so that installation finish. Okay, so we are done with installing and created a React app. Now we will go inside the directory learning, like this, cd learning one. Now to see all the files you have to open the folder that we have created, learning one. Select folder. Then you will see inside learning various folders like node modules, public source folder and package.json, readme.me. Now you will see the files inside public and source folder, index.html, in the source app.js, this is our main file, and index.js and package.json, that's where all the dependencies are. Here you can see React DOM, react scripts and all the scripts inside this and json file. These are the packages we required for running our React app. So this is the default React app structure. Now we will see how we can run this React app. Go to new terminal and then type npm start. This will redirect you to the localhost and you will see your React app is loading and this is on localhost. So this is how your default React app looks like. Okay, now see how we render these stuff on the browser. So we have index.html. This is the file, this is going to be displayed on the browser. So this looks like an empty file, but this has a div with id root. We are rendering this div in our browser as a result. Now see in the source folder we have also app.js and index.js. So let's open app.js and you have index.js also. So you will see in this React DOM dot render we are rendering the app component. We are rendering the app component inside the root, inside the root element, and root element we know where it's it is in index.html, this root element. So inside index.js React DOM dot render we are rendering the app element inside the root. And now we will see where this app element. So the app.js is app.js, in this we have app component. This is our app component. So basically this div is rendering on the browser. This is the functional component and you have to export it, like export default app. We will see this in further videos. So this is the basic structure how React app works and React structure works. Now we will see how JSX works. JSX is JavaScript XML. Using JSX you can write HTML structure inside the same JavaScript file. This is the JavaScript XML, that is JSX, and we use JSX to render the dynamic stuff. So let's have a look. I am going to delete all this default stuff of React am writing simple HTML stuff here. H1, let's say employee name, that is Ram. Then say employee age, that is 22. Then say technologies on which he is working, say full stack. Now see, this is the static stuff, and this will render to our web page. Employee name Ram, employee is 22, technology full stack. Now see how we can make these stuff dynamic. So I'm going to put all these property inside a single object, so that we can access via that object. Let's say where employee equals to, this is our object, and I am providing here property and value. So name, you can say Shyam this time. Then age of this employee, say 22. Then say tech, you can say Java developer. So I have wrapped up all these properties inside a single object. Now we can access these properties of this employee. We have already seen how we can access the properties in object. See, employee name, here I am going to put employee, that is object name dot name. So this will render employee name, and over here employee dot age, and here employee tech. Now see, employee name Shyam, employee is 22, technologies Java developer. Now you can switch also, like if you want to change name like Mahesh, and age let's say 25, then you can see employee name Mahesh and employee is 25. So this is how you can make dynamic stuff in JSX. Now see how we do conditional rendering in JSX. So let's say I want to display the employee status, whether it is a senior employee or a junior employee. So how can we find out this? Suppose I have set the age of the employee. If the age of the employee is less than 22, then it is a junior employee. And if the age of the employee is greater than 26, then you can say it is a senior employee. So for this, I am going to create a function is status, and I will pass here age. Then if now say age of the employee is less than 23, then return junior engineer, else return senior engineer. Now you have to call this function is status. So let's say h1 status is status, and inside this we will pass employee age, employee dot age. Now see, employee age 25, senior employee. If I put age of the employee say 21, then status is junior engineer. So this is how you can do conditional rendering in with JSX. So that's all about JSX. In the next video, we will see arrow functions and types of component, functional component or class component. This is all for today's lecture. Hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. And if you have any queries, you can comment in the comment box. You can also follow us on our social media handles. You can see the links here. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.